Okay. So what exactly do we need to do? That
we need to strengthen the regulatory authority of
the Banco Central,
not only over banks and financial institutions, but over subsidiaries and their sister affiliate companies, because sometimes the financial wrongdoing may not have been committed in the mother, but it may have been committed
in the subsidiary. Which will lead to the collapse of the mother.
Yes.
But what?
And throughout the world, if I may add, throughout the world, they are strengthening regulatory regime.
Like what happened in the U.S.
That's right.
Okay.
That's right.
Because it was too loose.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's really the poor that need attention most. And do you see any legislation that would hasten perhaps or cut down the number of poor in our country?
Is there any function?
It's an executive function.
No. It's both executive and legislative function. As I see it, you have to prioritize your spending. It has to be spending on those
on social services,
on
health.
Social services, and on roads, because those are the public goods available to the poor.
Mm-hmm.
You give him good education. Mm-hmm. You give him good health. You give him good access roads, then he'll take care of himself.
Mm-hmm.
So you've got to really be
tough. Isn't that
tough.
What PGMA was supposed to have done and brags that she had done?
Well, it's just
you know, the economy had grown uninterrupted, she claims, now for 37 quarters, etc. But then the gap between the rich and the poor just widened and the poor increased. Why did that happen?
That's the irony.
Why did they not benefit from this economic growth?
Because I think, apart from just roads and bridges and those access roads, you've got to take care of the social needs of
Dun
the poor.
That's where she failed to. Or because corruption also, no? Corruption
all of that.
Went unabated.
All of that, yes. Because if you improve education, you know, public education is mostly the one taken advantage of by the poor.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Health, our public health system is almost near collapse.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So you've got to take, and then housing, of course.
Mm-hmm. So when is this meeting with Kiko, or how will you go about it? Will you bring your seven with you when you meet with him?
Put him through the ringer?
What is it?
We're not that brutal. No, what I will suggest to him is, after talking to me...
Or what will you offer me? What committees? Yun ba yun?
Hindi. To me, that's the least I'm personally concerned with. I'm really more concerned about the whole setup. We've got a leader who will lead a reform Senate.
Okay.
So I will suggest to Kiko, after we talk, I promise you I'll talk to my group, but better that you also talk directly with every single one of them. Anyway,
how does that go? He convinces them why he's the one who they should vote for and not Villar and not Enrile.
Yes. Not in that dramatic way.
No, but what is the danger, perhaps, of having Villar there to Noynoy?
Well, the fact that he was a political rival.
There was a bitter fight between them.
It was a very bitter contest that they went through.
But then on the contrary, if he promises not to, as you said, not to be obstructionist, on the contrary, if you can get all your opponents to work together, wouldn't that be a political achievement for the president? Wouldn't that be?
You know the secret of Lincoln, why he was so successful? He managed a very disruptive civil war, and yet he has succeeded in unifying the nation, freeing the slaves. Because when he won, he recruited all his rivals, his state secretary.
That's why. Shouldn't that be a master stroke? In fact, if you get Senator Villar as the Senate president and work together like you did with FVR.
Well, President Noynoy must do a Lincoln.
Have you talked?
No, not yet.
Mm.
Yeah. Yeah.
But how are your how's your relationship with him?
Quite good, quite good. You know, I like Noy, you know, President Noy Noy. In fact, he's one of the few senators who stay up with us. Mm-hmm. I handle the budget kasi. Who stay up with us mm-hmm. until what 1-2 o'clock in the morning, mm-hmm. scrutinizing mm-hmm. The department, mm-hmm. the budget of
even if he didn't pass any law.
Yes, yes, no, but he's very diligent, very mm-hmm. and very mm-hmm. meticulous.
Mm-hmm. One final question: you worked with his mother. Yeah. You run in her first senatorial ticket. How do you compare the two?
There's no basis yet
no basis.
To compare.
Okay.
This only noise first week.
Okay.
Yes.
But seeing him in the Senate, what were
he's a very diligent. He's a very diligent, okay. very, very likable senator.
Can he make tough decisions?
Well, I'm not that close to him to be able to tell you that. But
And perhaps there was no opportunity yet at that time.
I hope. Okay. I hope he will do all some right. tough calls.
Okay. So with that, with the call for the president to do a Lincoln, we thank you for joining us. And you're very wise. Huh? You're now the one that holds the key to who will be the next Senate president.
It's a group.
All right.
It's a group. Well, just happened to be. Yeah.
Thank you very much for your time, Senator Angara.